we've got the domain. So now the first thing we've got to think of is the theme that you want to use. Now, WordPress.com and WordPress as a whole has seen a lot of changes within the last year or so. The main change is that the content is being built using what's called the block editor, which is a series of blocks, and you can drag and drop them into order, and they've got their whole range of settings, whereas the classic editor was more of your Word document style editor. So that's one thing to sort of to bear in mind. Now, with the block editor, that's now progressed into what's called the full site editor, where you can edit headers and footers and sidebars and the template in which that content sits. So you really do have much, much more control than you did before. So how does that apply to themes? So some themes are built with the block editor and full site editing in mind, and some themes aren't. So this is where you would need to think about, you know, how you want the theme to look and how you want it to function, and try and get a balance as to what you need and what you require. So let's talk a bit about themes and how you would choose a theme. If you see appearance on the right hand side there.
All right, is that and themes?
Themes, that's it, yeah. And then we'll try and pick a theme. I already have a theme in mind for you, but I'll, you know, I'll do my best to kind of guide you. So you kind of want something a little bit minimalist, and preferably a theme that's been released fairly recently. So the one I actually have in mind for your site is actually one called Appleton, which is it's like the second one there. It's, I think it's been released recently, but it's quite minimalist. What do you think? I'll let you have a look, and you can tell me what you think.
Yeah, I'll take a look. And I'm happy with the minimalist look.
Yeah.
Because I like something that's pretty clean, easy to follow. You know, nothing too complex. So sure. I'm okay with that one.
Sure. Okay. Cool. Yeah. I mean, you can change a theme at any time. But if you change a theme, you just have to make a few little tweaks here or there. That's the only thing. So okay, we'll have a click on the theme, a click on Appleton, and just have a look around. And if you click on that preview box, it should open it up a lot bigger, so you can have a look there.
Okay, there's the preview right here.
Yeah, you just click on the big image there. Yeah,
gotcha.
There you go. Yeah. So, like, it's very simple. The menu is hidden behind a little toggle on the right hand side. You've got a site title there, and then everything that comes under that is your content. Nice big images. Yeah. If you're on a basketball court, that's what you kind of want to see. I guess.
Yeah, I like these icons here. Go to my Instagram page. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, and you're not limited to just those ones. You can have YouTube and things like that if you need to as well, which is cool. So yeah, okay. Yeah. Well, if you're happy with that, click activate in the top right hand corner. Okay, so this bit here. Now you can start building the theme from scratch, or you can import the demo data, which I would recommend, and then just change it to suit your needs if you want. Okay. So I'd go for the right hand side. Replace my homepage content with the Appleton homepage. Yeah, that's the one you want. Yeah.